Good morning, all of you. I hope all of you got the homework answers. Okay, last class I gave three homeworks for you. All of you got its correct answer. Okay, now today we can discuss volume of three-dimensional shapes. What is mean by volume of a three-dimensional shape? Okay, volume is the amount occupied for a amount of space occupied by a three-dimensional object is called its volume. Suppose here if it is a cylinder, how much space we need for this, in this inside of this cylinder, how much space is occupied, that is mean by its volume. Okay, when we consider, if it is, suppose if it is a cuboid shape, this is a cuboid shape, then how much amount is space, amount of space, okay, how much space is occupied in this, that is its volume. So according to the shape of that object, its volume will be different. Okay, so for finding volume of a solid, we need to divide it into cubic, so small cubes. So okay, when we consider in the case of plane shapes, do you remember how we find out the area of this any plane shape or rectangle or square like that? So first we divide this full squares into full rectangle into small unit squares, and after that we count how many unit squares are there, that will be its area. Do you remember that? Okay, suppose all are unit squares. Okay, my drawing is not accurate. Then all in this rectangle, how many unit squares include, that will be its area. That we already learned in the lower classes. Suppose in this lengthwise, how many unit squares are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 unit square are there. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, in this breadthwise, 5 unit squares are there. Okay, so what will be its area? Total, how many unit square will be there? Total, to get the total number, we can multiply this 9 with 5. 9 into 5, 45 centimeter square will be its area. That we find out by taking its number, counting how many unit squares are there. Okay, then we find out a general equation for easy way. We find out the for rectangle. If it is 9 unit squares are there, its length will be 9. And if in this case, if it is 5 unit squares are there, its length will be 5. What is mean by unit square? A square with 1 centimeter length is unit square. So if 9 unit squares are arranged there, its length will be 9 centimeter. Just like if 5 unit squares are arranged in this way, its length will be 5 centimeter. So total how many unit squares will be there? Just multiply this 9 into 5, you will get 45. In this way we find out a general equation for finding area of a rectangle by multiplying length into breadth. So it is in the case of plane shape for finding area, just like in the case of three dimensional shape for finding the volume of this cuboid, any shape, cuboid or cylinder or cube. So in this we want to arrange unit cubes instead of unit squares. In the plane shapes we take unit squares, but in the case of three dimensional shape we arrange unit cubes. How many unit cubes we can arrange in this, how many unit squares, how many unit cubes we can occupy in this cuboid, that will be its volume. Okay, so for in this case when we arrange this full with the unit cubes, then how many unit cubes are there that we count, that will be its volume. So in the case of a cuboid, if we arrange, suppose if it is a, if we take this as length and its lengthwise, if it is arranged 5 cubes, its length we will take it is 5, and breadth, in the breadthwise if it is arranged 4, so breadth 4, and if it is height is 10. Okay, height if it takes the gas 10. So how many unit cubes will be there? How many unit cubes? In the lengthwise if we arrange 5, and in the breadthwise if we arrange 4, and it, up to each column, that is height, if you take it as 10, how many total unit cubes there? You want to multiply this. Okay, 5 into 4 into 10, 20 into 10, so 200. So its unit, volume of this cuboid will be 200 centimeter cube. Its unit we will take as cubes, centimeter cube. Why? Because we are counting how many unit cubes are there. So its unit becomes cube. In this plane shape we arranged unit squares. So it's a unit we take it as square centimeter. Here cube, cubical centimeter, or centimeter cube, or meter cube, like that. So in this case also it is not possible, always it is not possible to count how many unit cubes we can arrange in there. That is not possible always. So we are finding general equations for finding volume of each shape, cube, cuboid, and cylinder. So first we take cube. If it is cube, we know in the case of cube always we take the length, one length, side length we take it as a. So its volume will be what? We want to multiply length into breadth into height. So in the case of cube, it will be all will be a. So a into a into a, that means a square into a, that a cube. So volume of a cube is a cube. So in the case of cuboid we take length as l and breadth as b and height as h. So the cuboid volume will be equal to lbh. Okay, now we can find out if for any three dimensional shapes the volume will be base area. First we find out the base area, then when that multiply with its height we will get its volume. Okay, for any cuboidal shape, for generally we can find out volume V is equal to base area into height. So in the case of cube, you look, base area is a square and multiply with its height. Your height also a, so a square into a cube. Then in the case of cuboid, base area, this is in rectangle shape, so length into its area will be length into breadth, so lb, that multiply with its height, lbh. Just like in the case of cylinder also, cylinder, what will be the volume of cylinder? If you take cylinder, base will be which shape? You know, that is circle. Then circle area, we know that is pi r square. With radius r, its area will be pi r square, and that multiply with its height, then pi r square h. So these generally we want to find out the equation for finding volume of any three dimensional shape, that will be base area multiply with its height. Then for each shape we can find out, if it is a cube, its base area will be a square, then a square into a cube. So volume of cube equal a cube. In the case of cuboid, base area, cuboid, the base will be in rectangle shape, so its base area is length into breadth, that multiply with the height, so lbh. Area, volume of a cuboid is equal to lbh. So in the case of cylinder, volume of cylinder is equal to pi r square h. Okay, base is circle shape, so its area is pi r square, that multiply with its height h, so pi r square h. Okay, using this we can find out volume of this three shapes. And also one thing we want to care, when we convert centimeter cube into meter cube into centimeter cube, that also we want to care. So here we look that a unit also we want to care in the case of volume. So we know one cubic centimeter equal, how we can take three dimensions. So 1 centimeter into 1 centimeter. So it will be how much when we convert into millimeter? Here 1 centimeter, 10 millimeter into 10 millimeter into 10 millimeter. Okay, so how much millimeter total is there? 1000 millimeter. Okay, so 1 cubic centimeter is equal to, 1 cubic centimeter we can represent as centimeter cube. So 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1000 millimeter. So we know 10 millimeter make 1 centimeter. But when we convert cubes, in the case of cubes, we want to 1 centimeter cube will be equal to 1000 millimeter. Just like when we convert meter cube into centimeter cube, that also we know 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Okay, when we convert in meters into centimeter, we are multiplying with 100 only. But in the case of when we convert meter cube into centimeter cube, we want to multiply with 3 centimeters are there. So 100 into 100 into 100, that much zeros we want to take. Okay, so the answer will be, when we convert this into that much centimeter cube, so 10 lakhs centimeter cube will be equal to 1 meter cube. That you want to clear. So normally we are, when we convert meters into centimeter, we only multiply with 100. But that one to clear, when we convert centimeter cube into meter cube or meter cube into centimeter cube, we want to take this number. Okay, then its problem, related problems, we can discuss next class. Okay, thank you.